I now call upon Father Ignatius Hadimulia Sasmita of the Society of Jesus to offer our invocation for today's ceremony. Father Hadi.
Let us pray and be mindful of God's presence among us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Dear God, this afternoon we are celebrating your blessings and graces upon the Pyronautz. We are grateful for the rain, but please God, hold off on the rain until the celebration is over. During their 4 years, the Pyronautz have navigated through different fires, the pandemic, the separation due to border closing, junior Kairos, different delays of senior Kairos, and other obstacles along the way. God, you are the master of all navigators. You have guided our navigators through the fire, bringing their hearts even closer to share a bit of stronger unity, full of life, full of love, full of colors sent from you above. Dear God, please bless our graduation ceremony with abundant joy, celebrating the accomplishment of your children, the Pyronautz, the teaching and guidance by the faculty and staff, and the loving care of their families and friends. As the Pyronautz are moving on, may they always remember Mabuchi Hill, where the love is true. As they sail out into the world, may your stars brightly shine upon their destiny, enthusiastically sharing their boundless love amongst everyone. We humbly offer this prayer through your Son, Jesus Christ, the master of all navigators, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Saint Francis Xavier,
thank you, Father Hadi. The graduates will lead us in singing the national anthem of the Federated States of Micronesia. You will find the words printed in your program. Miss Melarisa and Anthony Young Mori will lead us in the song.
This year we are pledging with hearts and with hands, full measure of devotion to thee, our native land. Full measure of devotion to thee, our native land. Now all join the chorus, let union abide across all Micronesia. Join hands on every side across all Micronesia, join hands on every side. We all work together with hearts, voice, and hands till we have made these silence another promised land. Till we have made this silence another promised land.
The smiles on our faces, we Distinguished guest, former Vice President Killian, Speaker Masai, Board Member Asaguchi, and many other dignitaries who are joining us this day, parents, family, faculty, staff, and especially members of our graduating class, welcome to our 67th commencement address here at Xavier High School Micronesia. It gives me great pleasure to welcome you today to this court to celebrate the achievements these graduates have done over these past 4 years. Even though these we say go and set the world on fire, these students have been on fire with love, with passion this past year, and I think that's why maybe God's trying to put out the fire a little bit so they stay, you know, stay just normal. We don't burn down the house right now. Put Sopwith on fire. But we welcome everybody here, especially those who traveled from near and far by boat and plane, by car up the jarring road to Mabuchi Hill to be with us today. We are honored by your presence. And take solace for every bump you endured on the road here. It's a bit of time off in purgatory. To our soon-to-be graduates, you too faced a bumpy road to get to the stage, as alluded to previously and will be alluded to many times before. I'm so impressed with your determination and resiliency that you demonstrated in the face of significant challenges over these past 4 years to arrive at this moment. The online classes, transferring back and forth to other schools when you come to Chuuk, the extensive quarantines that some of you faced, masking, social distancing, the loss of loved ones, enduring illnesses of your own. As St. Francis Xavier did before you, you trusted in the Lord along the way as you bravely faced many uncertainties, perils, and challenges that made this moment possible. Class of 2023, my heartfelt congratulations to you this day. I'm with you always, and this is always your home. With that said, let's get our commencement underway.
Thank you, Father Todd. I now call upon faculty member and class moderator, Ms. Stephanie Carlisle, to introduce our salutatorian from the graduating class. Ms. Stephanie.
Good afternoon. Our next speaker is someone whose impact on the Xavier community would be hard to miss. Her teachers know her to be a conscientious, capable, hard-working student who brings a genuine curiosity and energy to her work. When asked to describe her, fellow students use words like confident, responsible, outgoing, loud. Nearly everyone mentioned her skills as a leader and as a speaker who is unafraid to say what she really means. Many also pointed to her care for others, which she has expressed in her dedication to such leadership roles as junior class president and SBA president. She's a considerate classmate who frequently checks in to see how others are doing, even those who may not be close friends or who outwardly seem fine. I've been impressed by this student's work ethic, self-awareness, and emotional intelligence. And I think I can speak for the rest of the faculty in saying that we are so proud to be sending her off to Sophia University as one of this year's recipients of the APIC Sophia Scholarship. She deserves it. Please give a big round of applause to this year's salutatorian, Isabella Sophia Costacat.
Iyam ogaselelia mengo. Monei pan tola na nechmo sakarata, ay wow o kapung kalangan on sama chai coach, wagi asmakin mor o kapaikan meleratong chai ranch. Upupana pasa ay kapasen krisongeri aminirisin. Amusara tepis usrei fosin tuk, so I will be speaking English during the speech. Greetings, ladies and gentlemen. Before I make my remarks, I would like to give my utmost respect and gratitude to our Heavenly Father, who has given us all the opportunity to be present here today in celebrating the 67th commencement exercise of Xavier High School's Class of 2023, the Pyronautz. I would like to give my respects to the President of the Federated States of Micronesia, the Honorable Wesley Simina. Respect and gratitude to the Honorable Governor Alexander Naru. Respect and gratitude to our keynote speaker, the Honorable Speaker Danny Mersai. My respects and gratitude to Mr. Myron Hashiguchi and Mr. Redley Killian. Respects and gratitude to our school president, Father Todd Kenny. Respects and gratitude to our principal, Mr. Martin K. Carl. And my respect to all church leaders, government leaders, traditional leaders, teachers, friends, and family. Again, welcome to Xavier High School. It is truly an honor and privilege to be standing here today and addressing the salutatory speech. Today, I stand before you in representing 30 beautiful minds and souls. To add along, today these 30 hearts represent 22 other people who have yet to return due to many unforeseen circumstances. 52 might have turned into 30, but on behalf of the Pyronauts, we would like to recognize these people who have made a great impact on what our class has accomplished. These people are Respila Liwele Morris, Rodner Nana, Bradley Wolbacher, Gwyneth Danis, Sieli Irons, J.R. Henley, Mary Mac Bumba Moses, Charlene Sakius, Jeremy Conrad, Kea Phillip, Xavier Kaminaga, Edson Asher Sam, Trevor Winey, Kata Rafin, Tulik Regalut, Dracle Andreas, Tomoya Sungino, Iahad Adi Singapau, James Kanai, Sydney Francisco, Royce Isset, and Chloe Patrice. You all might not be present on the stage with us, but your names will forever remain with us and also our Pyronauts group chat. Honestly, I don't know how I'm standing up here because unfortunately I have been suffering from senioritis, or in other words, sleeping in class, turning in assignments at the last minute, and using the "it's my last year" excuse this whole year. I was contemplating on what to write in this speech for so long that I decided to start writing it at 2 a.m. in the morning while listening to Chucky's Riofo songs. I don't know how, but those songs really helped. I was giving many different pieces of advice on what to talk about. Some said to leave an impactful message. Some said to talk about my time here at Xavier. But most of my classmates said to do what we've been doing for the past 4 years of our high school lives, which is to just wing it. If I had to make a recap of my years here at Xavier High School, I would say more good than bad. The good times would be the times our class would be doing whatever in our classroom during study, and then awkwardly grabbing a book or waking up from the floor because someone yells, "Hey, hey, Mr. Carl's coming." But the best of times would be when Reiner rushes through the classroom to do a cartwheel, and Deshaun body rolling just to prove to us that they are the most athletic and best dancers of our class. Don't get me started on when they sing from the top of their lungs during prayer. I never knew that 29 people would make such an impact on my life. Like Evelyn once said, it is as if Savior is all I have ever known. It truly does feel that way. I don't know how I will be able to go about my days without hearing these guys make fun of my forehead every 5 minutes. But despite that, I will truly miss you all. I believe that this day should be a day to recognize these 29 people, starting with Gina, Nana, Jamarin, and Tia. These four are the true definition of Chuki's niyakapes. But don't let them fool you, because they know how to own a dance floor. Sean Angelo, Netta, and Yuri. I'd like to thank you all for sharing your notes and paying attention for us in class. You three are truly appreciated. Nia and Lena, thank you for dealing with all of us this whole year and not letting your frustration get to you when we don't listen. Nia bringing up food and Lena's nicknames will forever be cherished. Sarah and Evelyn, you two have accomplished so much for the girls' community. Hopefully your willingness to shape these girls will also stop the toilets from being out of order. Denzel and Glenn, you two might not say much in class, but thank you for brightening up our days with your accents. Gaipo, Naveen, and Paul, I think I speak on behalf of all of us when I say that I hope you three finally agree that all of your religions are beautiful. Hoku, Myla, and Maya, I'm glad to say that this class has found three responsible babysitters for their future children. Jada and Sasa, thank you for bringing us your unique recipes to feed us. If you two ever decide to open up a restaurant, I hope you put your famous musubi and crab rangoons as the Pyronautz special. Layla and Kika, I don't know what I am going to do without your daily bickering of who's right and who's wrong. But whatever or wherever we end up in life, I hope you two remember to WhatsApp me every now and then. Iguamet, I know you're going to miss this class taking your phone and wasting your storage, but at least you have a collage of all our faces. Deshaun, I feel like everyone is going to miss you and your random moments, or the moments you like to call daily dose of cutie. Reiner, also known as the next winner of America's Got Talent, your hard work has paid off and you can now do as many cartwheels as you'd like. Grant, thank you for being patient and keeping the sanity in our class. I hope you know that you're the only one that can handle our crazy. Anakin, I know one day you'll become a famous TikToker. Let's just wait on that. Bryn, I hope you don't fall today, but if you do, we will add it as one of the many funny and unforgettable memories you have given us. The little things you all do is what I will remember the most about you all. Thank you for keeping up with me, even though I can be hard-headed at times. You have all shown me what it's like to have a family away from family. Xavier has brought us all both joy and sorrow, but I am so glad to see or to say that I have survived those times because of how Xavier has taught me to be strong. Nothing compares to Xavier. From the early morning bumpy bus rides to the first wave of the smell of the pig pen during classes, to the 2 laps around the field that feels like 6 laps, to the loud students screaming Dancing Queen from the top of their lungs, to the Monday and Friday macro lunches, and to the late night shopping trips. Xavier is nothing but love to all, even if it means shedding a tear every now and then. To our mamas of Xavier, thank you for fixing us food, doing laundry for the boys, and letting us sing sad songs to you all. Thank you for making us feel that we have second moms here on campus. To our papas, thank you for waking up early to pick us up on the bus and arriving home late just to make sure we got to where we needed after school. Although our loudness and playlist of rap songs, sad songs, and siren jams were annoying at times, we hope those songs remind you of us whenever you hear them. to the teachers, faculty, and staff of Xavier. We know how difficult it has been for you to teach such a bipolar class. You are all with us during our bad days and good days. But now it is safe to say that your hard work on preparing us has paid off. To Ms. Margie and Father Hadi, thank you for loving us throughout all our flaws. We hope your future students give you as many smiles as we did. To the Salvatorians, the Decalians, and the Aeronauts, we have seen you all grow so much throughout this year. I want you all to remember that even though some may say that Xavier now is not like the Xavier before, it is your job to make Xavier what you want it to be. You don't need a trophy or a certificate of recognition or other people to tell you that you are doing a good job. You being here and present enough makes you all become the competent, conscientious, and compassionate students you ought to be. Like one said, sometimes it might not be the best being here, but it is always the best being from here. To my Nona and Baba, first of all, I want to thank you too for raising me to become the person I am today. Happy birthday, Mom. I'm sorry I couldn't buy you expensive perfume or buy you nice jewelry, but I hope this will do. To my brothers, cousins, uncles, and aunties, thank you all for your support throughout these past few years. I love you all, even if it means I have to listen to you all make fun of my haircut every now and then. And to Grandpa Bill, Mama Melba, Uncle Yatvin, Auntie Corky, Auntie Shorty, Gavin, Vinny, Vinky, and Yasmin, thank you for taking care of me and Kika. I hope this speech shows a portion of how much you all mean to us. Jermaine and Monica, you two have been my number one supporters through thick and thin. Kailangan and Kuma. And lastly, although you two aren't with me, and I still think you two left me too soon, this one's for you, Auntie Kiki and Mama Nancy. I hope heaven has given you both what you deserve, which is love and peace. And although I did not mention everyone that I have met throughout my years here, I want to thank everyone. Kalangan, Luso, Kamagar, Sulang, Gulo, and Komol Tata. I hope you enjoy the rest of your afternoon.
Thank you, Mrs. Sibylla Postica. I now call upon our outgoing senior class president, Ms. Nia Robert from the state of Chu, to introduce our commencement speaker. Ms. Robert.
Ladies and gentlemen and esteemed guests, good afternoon. I am very privileged to have this opportunity to introduce our keynote speaker today. Our speaker is a familiar face in our school. He is an alumnus of Xavier High School's Centurion class of 2000. After graduating from Xavier, he pursued a liberal arts education at Chaminade University in Honolulu, after which he attended the University of Hawaii at Leeward to pursue a degree in business marketing and is currently pursuing a business administration degree at the University of the People Online Institution. Proving that anyone who stops learning is old, whether at 20 or 80, anyone who keeps learning stays strong, young. He embodies being a man for others through his service on various boards and commissions. In the following years, he has served the people of Chuuk. In 2009 to 2013, he served as a member of the Chuuk Chamber of Commerce. In 2013 to 2014, he became a member of the FSM Association of the Chamber of Commerce. He is also currently the vice president of the FSM Athletics Association, which shows his love for the youth. The people of Chuuk spoke and elected him to be a member of the House of Representatives in 2014 to 2015. Since then, he has been instrumental in his role as chairman of the Health and Welfare Committee, member of the Ways and Means Committee in 2015 to 2017, chairman of the Judiciary and Governmental Operations Committee, member of the Ways and Means Committee in 2017 to 2019, And in 2019 to 2021, he was again elected as a member of the House of Representatives and was the floor leader of the House. In 2021 to 2023, he became the Speaker of the House of Representatives. Currently in his ninth year, he remains as Speaker of the House and a member of the Ways and Means Committee. He has been an inspiration to many generations of Xavier navigators. He and his family have been helpful and generous to the Xavier community by hosting and sponsoring Xavierites. He is always ready to share a story or two about his time spent on Mabuchi Hill, which brings out smiles, laughter, and inspiration in the eyes of the new generation of Xavierites. Today, I am proud and privileged to introduce to you our keynote speaker and son of Xavier, Speaker Lester Daniel Mersai.
Thank you very much, Ms. Robert, for the kind introduction. So quiet. A quick announcement, if you're wearing a nice looking Crocs, please return it to me after this. I left it at the study hall. I'm sorry, just standing here in front of a crowd here at Xavier, it kind of brings back memory. You get to stand up and make announcements like that. Such a wonderful day here on Mabuchi. Last time I was up here was 23 years ago, my graduation. The first class that graduated on this very court. A member of the cool century young class of 2000, so we say. But don't get mistaken, I was just up here sitting. I wasn't giving any speeches during our graduation. So with the given task for me today, I wanna specifically thank the Pyronautz, faculty and staff, Xavier family, for giving me the opportunity to stand here to deliver a speech after 23 years. Thank you. Oh, if I don't sound clear, please forgive me. I just had my allergies on my way up here. The last time I had my allergies was 23 years ago. So forgive me if I don't sound clear. I want to pay my respect to Father Todd Kenny. I'm used to saying director of Xavier High School, president of Xavier High School. My respect to you, Mr. Carr, principal, all faculty and staff and students, members of the board of Xavier High School, Mr. Myron Asukichi, Naitiro, Vice President Killian, Speaker Fritz. Respect to all dignitaries, national, state, traditional, and church leaders. I would like to extend my respect to all distinguished guests, families that have traveled from our neighboring islands, our local families and friends. My respect to you all. My respects to all alumni of Xavier High School. I see so many faces here in the audience. Don't worry, me standing here 23 years later doesn't make me feel old or make you feel even older. I would like to acknowledge a brother of mine, although he's here as a parent, but in his capacity I want to pay my respect to Senator Walter from Pohnpei State Legislature, Iroa. I can feel their heart pounding, praying that I don't mention their name. But their hearts are pounding with joy. As proud parents of the graduates, I want to recognize my classmates, the two Sandy Queens from the Centurion class of 2000, Trish and Jennifer. I know you don't want this, but congratulations. But most especially, I want to pay my respect to the graduating class of 2023. Mighty road to each and every one of you. Ladies and gentlemen, Yahweh, Lenwo, Kaselelie, Moketin, Ali, Kumusta? Konnichiwa. What's up? And Raranim. It's a joyous day, a beautiful day, a day to celebrate, a day to remember, and a day to give thanks. Above all, let's give glory to God, praise Him, and give Him thanks for everything, especially for today. I would like to extend my utmost appreciation to the graduating class and the Xavier family for the opportunity not only to witness, but to be a part of this special occasion. It is truly an honor to be here, to be selected among 1,000 notable people to be the keynote speaker. Right, Mr. Carl? Or I probably misread your letter. I don't know if it said 1,000 or a few notable people. On a serious note, I'm very honored. However, this is a very difficult task. I know this because I'm sure these graduates can't wait to party, right? No, you don't live the life of party. I'm sure by tonight, they're gonna forget everything I say today. So last night I asked my son, Caden, do you remember everything that was said during your graduation? He said, yeah, but I don't believe him. So I'm sure this graduate will not remember everything I say. So before proceeding on, how's everybody feeling today?
Good.
Come on, it's a joyous day for them and for us. How is everybody feeling today? Good. You know, in order to keep these graduates awake during my address, I need your participation, the audience's participation. Please, if I say something and you find it funny, laugh out loud. If you don't find it funny, I beg you, please laugh out loud. And please, not the new generation way of laughing out loud. I think it goes something like, lol, or... I would humbly ask everyone's participation. After all, you and I are here, and it's for them. First of all, I want to congratulate the Pyronauts, Navigators of Fire, the graduating class of 2023. Let me just say this, you guys look fabulously gorgeous, you guys on fire. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give it up for the Pyronauts. Xavier High School. There's something about this place that even alumni before me still can't explain. You become one with this place. It's hard to detach yourself from here. You know, parents, we take pride naming our child or our children. But I tell you, you come to Xavier, your name changed. Everybody have the same name. For 4 years, I was called Nan. I'm serious, and that name is called in many different tone. Like, Nan, you look cool. Nan, can I borrow a pen? Nan, you on Saturday work? Nan, you got A in Mr. Carl's class? Something about this place. And the scary part is, you can't stop talking about Savior life. I mean, when you're up here on Savior, on campus, you talk about Savior, right? When you go home, you talk about Savior. When you go home for the break, all you talk about is about Savior. After you graduate, you still talk about Savior. Look at me, after 23 years, I'm still talking about Savior. Who knows, one day you and I could be talking about Savior to the angels. Another year, another accomplishment. 67th graduation commencement exercise. Wow. I want to take this opportunity to express our congratulations, most especially our gratitude to Father Todd, Mr. Carl, faculty and staff. We thank you for all that you have done for us, our children, our communities, our states, and our nations. Your mission to educate young men and women of our nations mentally, physically, and spiritually have shaped the way we are today as a community and as a nation. The school's endless commitment and dedication will forever be remembered and honored by parents, families, our communities, and our governments. Father Todd, President or Director of Xavier High School. Father Todd Kenny was my general science teacher my freshman year. I think he was my favorite teacher, although I never really have good grades in his class. Father Todd, it's always nice to have you come back and continue this for our children. We have faith in you, and we thank you for all that you do for our children's future. Mr. Carl and all faculty and staff, you have replaced so many parents over the years. You are practically the true parents of these graduates and students. Thank you. I think it is fitting that the parents should sign off the legal guardianship to you guys. But on a serious note, thank you very much. Like the Jesuits before always say, Kirisho Chapur. Pyronauts, navigators of fire. Should we get this place lit? Yeah. We gotta make them hear. Should we get this place lit?
Yeah!
Come on, you're graduating. 4 years gone by fast, huh? Who's ready to leave? We should cancel this graduation. Nobody wants to leave Xavier. You navigated your way here, equipped with what you may need to get through Xavier High School. Leaving your homes at a young age was a hard decision. You came here as a young kid, and I applaud your courage to leave your parents, your families, and your homes to come to Xavier. It takes very few people to have the guts to make such decision to come to Xavier. That decision was not made not only by you, but with your parents, of course. I want to give credit to the parents. The final decision was made by your parents. I mean, parents, you'll be the one paying for the tuition, right? Shouldering all costs for the time and everything here. They made that decision so you can get the best education and for your future. Am I right, parents? Oh, you didn't make that decision? But let me tell you the truth behind the decision your parents made 4 years ago. Your tuition, that's basically called babysitting fee. No offense, Mr. Carl. Your parents decided that you come to Xavier 4 years ago because, seriously, they want you out of the house. Maybe they're tired of you that they're sending you away. Parents, you're smiling, but it could be the truth. Just kidding. Expect a lot of confrontation, interrogations from your graduating sons and daughters after this. To the returning students, you can confront your parents when you go home. Just make sure you don't tell them I said it. Proud parents, I congratulate you as well. Your child's accomplishment is your success. Pyronauts, you came here determined and focused on yourself only, meeting new strangers, new teachers, new environment. I know it was not easy. Coming together, coming up with a class name, that calls for something. Effort put together to be united. You named your class the Pyronauts. Believe me, I had to Google what and who are the Pyronauts. But I don't need to Google further, I just have to ask. Right, Layla? Pyronauts, navigators of fire. Your class so significant among all the classes that I know here at Xavier High School. Your arrival here at Xavier High School shook the world. Your first school year was the year when the world shut down. It was COVID year. I don't know if it's Pyronauts, navigators of fire, or navigators of fires. It's a joke. Just kidding. Please don't navigate the fire and burn me down on stage. Unfortunately, your class was separated due to COVID. It was hard for the school. It was hard for you as well. Your class so significant, you totally skipped being underclassmen here at Xavier. You guys so lucky. When I was an underclassman, I did a lot of morning glory work, afternoon work, and I mean cleaning the benzo, you know, I mean assigned by the upperclassmen. Now, despite the challenges you had to face, you are the Pyronauts. You kept the fire burning, you navigated that fire back to Xavier, and you kept it burning. You grew to know each other. You know each other's weaknesses and strengths, like stories and secrets. Who took Layla's Crocs? Who's the class clown? Who's the class genius? Like who's dating who? Am I right? You do things together. You look out for each other. You learn from each other. Learn from each other's mistakes. But most importantly, you understand yourself and you understand each other. Like our motto, ut omnes urum sint, that all may be one. You know, when I first got to Xavier, I really thought that ut omnes urum sint means that all may be saint. I'm like, ooh, that's a hard thing to do. You know, with the guidance and wisdom from your teachers and staff, you were able to make decisions or choices that brought you to this day. You are preparing your way to set sail on your next journey. You are living here as an adult filled with attributes and skills that you've acquired through the years here at Xavier that will equip you on your next journey. Don't be discouraged. I know you're ready. Alumni of Xavier High School, and I know they can relate, we get so many questions about Xavier. The most common question is, how did you survive Xavier? Let me tell you the secret of surviving Xavier. And I know they know the secret. It's macaron. Full of protein. The real answer to survive Xavier is all about decision making. Making choices. Your decision making here at Xavier leads you to this day, graduation day. Just for the record, I make decisions and choices through my years at Xavier to get me through. Decisions like, when we were hungry, I never come up with the idea to enter and get food from the faculty lounge. When we stay up late at night talking stories and I'm tired the next day, I never fall asleep in class. When I'm not ready for a quiz or a test, I never pretend to go to the infirmary and say I'm not feeling well. When the sign on the door says, no boys allowed, I never go in the girls' lounge. Or I never decided to switch around the cross on the St. Francis Xavier statue so he can look like he's pointing a gun. I'm very caring and very concerned about my friends. That when they're using the benzo and they hung their clothes outside so it doesn't get that beautiful benzo scent, I never take their clothes and bring it to the study hall, hung it up and write claim on the chalkboard. Or when I have a mountain pile of dirty clothes, I never save or borrow somebody's shirt. Although somebody took my underwears. So you see, it's very important to make this kind of decisions. I know you did. That's why you're here on stage. So one day you can stand where I'm standing, try not to feel guilty and talk about the decisions you made here at Xavier. You're sitting up here because you deserve it. You worked hard, you sacrificed, and you believed in yourselves. But this is not the end of your journey. You are about to set sail. The horizon will be filled with so many possibilities, opportunities, and of course, adversities. I know that you are capable, you're significant, you're courageous, and you are ready. For this is what Xavier is all about, preparing and getting you ready for this interesting and unpredictable journey. Your future is determined by your decision, by the decision you make. College awaits you. College and life is a vast ocean. It's your decision on how you sail and where to sail. Along your journey, you will encounter rough seas. That's peer pressure and temptations. but it's all up to you. Whatever decision and choices you make, you will have to live up to the consequences. But don't forget, regardless if your decision will lead to failure, do know that failure is the foundation of success. I mean, how would life be if there are no failures? It is impossible for life to be all successful without failure. I was always on Saturday work because of the decisions I made, the choices I made, like getting an ice cream from the faculty lounge and sharing it with one of the faculty without him knowing it was from their faculty lounge. They found out later I was on Saturday work. I never eat ice cream from the faculty lounge then, after that. College is a bit different. You're on your own. Think twice before you decide and make the right choices. It is really important prior to untie the rope for your canoe and sail on, you must set your course. Your course is your purpose. You must know your purpose. Set your compass on your purpose. Whether is it for your, is, it's for yourself, your purpose is for your family, your island, or your country. You must set your compass on your purpose. Without your purpose, you will keep sailing through the vast ocean of life and college and not reach your destination. In all that you do, always keep in mind that you must be men and women for others. Sail on, but always hold on to your roots, your family, especially your identity. Always remember and acknowledge and hold dear in your heart those that sacrificed their time, their shoulder for you to cry on, their words of wisdom and encouragement, their countless hours waking up early to pick you up, maintaining the campus for you, preparing good food like mackerel to give you strength, your sponsors that took you in to be a part of their family, your families, and the many prayers for your success. Hold on tight to all that I've mentioned, for they will be the wind that pushes your sail forward. And please know that you are not alone on your journey. Let God be the guiding star on your voyage. Always have faith in Him, for He has a purpose for you. Fun fact, before I sit down. Pyronauts. So I just found out that pyro is a Greek word for fire. Truly speaking, without fire, there is no real life, and that is scientifically proven. Most common misconception is that fire is bad and it's dangerous. You watch the news on Facebook, on social media, that the forest is on fire or places are burned down. But we often forget to accept that fire plays a major role in our ecosystem. Fire specifically cleans out everything and stimulates new plants. After each and every fire, the ecosystem regenerates and maintains a healthy system. Ladies and gentlemen, families and friends, we gather here today surrounding this fire to congratulate them and bid them farewell. Because as they leave, the ecosystem here at Xavier High School will regenerate and maintain a healthy system. So Pyronauts, you should go out and... Come on, let's let them hear them. I mean, hear it. It's your graduation. Pyronauts, you should go out and...
Fire.
We need to have the food ready. I think everybody's hungry. I have to cut it short then. Since I talked about decision making and choices, this is the only tool that will get you through college. Think twice, make the right decision. Ladies and gentlemen, families and friends, since I talked about decision making and choices, I want to apologize to each and every one of you, families and friends, if I bore you with my speech. But please don't blame me. Blame them. And them. It was their decision that I come up and stand here, not mine. It's been an honor. I feel very blessed, along with the graduates. So once again, I congratulate you, the Pyronauts class of 2023. Your future is determined by the decision and choices you make. Kirisho Jabur.
Thank you, Speaker Versailles, for that wonderful speech. I now call upon Ms. Margie Carl, class of 2015, senior class moderator and faculty member, to introduce our valedictorian. Ms. Margie.
Good afternoon, everyone. It is my pleasure to introduce our valedictorian speaker for this year's graduation ceremony. The student has demonstrated exceptional academic achievement, leadership skills, and a commitment to serving our Xavier community. He has consistently shown a passion for learning and a drive to succeed. As the top-ranked student in this year's graduating class, this individual is a shining example of what it means to be a dedicated and hard-working student and a man for and with others. To many, this individual is known for his outstanding weaving skills, his tenacious energy, and his impressive moves on the dance floor. Throughout my 4 years as the Pyronaut class moderator, I have witnessed remarkable growth, a keen sense of understanding, and pure compassion for the student. I undoubtedly believe that he will carry on these values as he embarks on his journey to Fairfield University this fall. Without further ado, I am honored to present to you our valedictorian speaker, Mr. Reiner Franz Viajador Rodriguez.
Thank you very much, Ms. Margie, for that kind introduction. Before I begin my speech, I would like to convey my humble respects to everybody present. My respect to the Xavier High School administration, faculty, and staff. My respect to all parents, sponsor parents, and families. My respect to all distinguished guests, our keynote speaker, Mr. Lester Danny Mersai, Board of Directors, Mr. Myron Hashiguchi, and Vice President Bradley Killian. And my respect to my fellow graduates, the Pyronauts. Tiro Wabi. To our Yapis families, Mogitin. To our Palawan families, Ali. To our Chukis families, Rarenim. To our Pompeian families, Kasilelia Menko or Kajilel Kamoy. To our Koshayan families, Lenwo. To our Marshallese families, Yakwe. To our Japanese families, Konnichiwa. To our Filipino families, Mabuhay and Mayong Hapon. Greetings to you all. I am deeply honored to be given the opportunity to speak in front of all of you and to represent my fellow graduates. Being given the opportunity to give this speech was all thanks to everybody who helped me throughout my journey here in Xavier. All teachers, staff, benefactors, and most importantly, my fellow classmates. I dedicate this speech to each and every person who shaped and molded me into the person I am today. This achievement is not mine alone, but it is an achievement that would not be possible without the help and support of each and every one of you. If I were to describe my time at Xavier with one song, I'd choose We Know the Way from the Disney animated film Moana. During this semester, I was part of the musical theater elective alongside Tishon, Layla, Naveen, Gina, and Laynette,
where we performed Moana in a play. When we sang this song during the play, I couldn't help but feel embarrassed and shy on stage. I was red all over from the embarrassment because of how I could not reach the high notes or follow the pitch. However, when I look back at that memory, I realized that that song was calling out to me just like how the sea called out to Moana. It would be the song that would describe my 4 years here in Xavier. The lyrics and the message of Moana's navigator ancestors finding their way throughout the vast ocean filled with uncertainties were perfect for the description I needed to describe my life on Mabuchi Hill. The Xavier experience is difficult, honestly. There were plenty of moments when I felt like giving up and just running away from all of the problems that Xavier faced me with. There is a famous Xavier saying that goes, "The road up to Xavier is bumpy and difficult, but the road through Xavier is even harder." Although the road up to Xavier has become smoother, the potholes of stress and challenges on the road through Mabuchi remain. Throughout my journey at Xavier, I experienced many rough waves that almost sunk my canoe countless times. My Xavier journey would not be easy without the presence of my fellow Pyronauts, the class of 2023. They were the first people I ever met here, and they will be the last people I say goodbye to as they leave on the ship and on flights going to their respective home islands. Without my classmates, I mean family, I would not be the person I am today because they have guided me through my tough times. They were the people who gave me a shoulder to lean on and a lunchbox to feast on. My boys, Naveen, Iguame, Denzel, Paul, Deshaun, Kaipo, Sean, Grant, Anakin, and Glenn were the people I have lived with through struggles of not eating enough food, complaining about having mackerel again, or getting bitten by mosquitoes late at night. My girls, Sasa, Gina, Layla, Kika, Isabella, Jada, Jamarine, Nana, Tia, Nia, Netta, Asante, Bryn, Evelyn, Yuri, Maya, Myla, Hoku, and Sarah were the people who would bring us food and drinks from town, or even bring their iron just to iron the gown that I'm wearing today. These people that I have just named are the people who have gone out of their way to make my life on Mabuchi Hill easier and more enjoyable. To all aspiring Xavierites and current Xavierites, listen up. It may seem like everything is a blur right now and that time is ticking so slow, but you will do it. You can run that race and make it to the finish line. One mistake I don't want you to make is to count the time until you make it out of Xavier. Instead of counting the time you have left here in Xavier, make precious memories instead. Time on this beautiful hill runs very slowly, but when you are on this graduation stage looking back at all of the memories, you will realize that time actually does fly very fast. Look at the person next to you. These people are the people who you will be seeing for the next few years of your journey here on Mabuchi Hill. Make the most of your time here in Xavier. Make new friends, laugh and love harder with the people around you, and create an impactful presence that you will be proud of. The future is bright for all of us, so embrace the blessings that you have been bestowed with. It's normal to make mistakes, but don't let those mistakes define you. Instead, let those mistakes be stepping stones for growth into the people you dream to be. Dream, dream, dream is my advice for all of you, current Xavierites. As Martin Luther King Jr. stated, if you can't fly, then run. If you can't run, then walk. If you can't walk, then crawl. But whatever you do, you have to keep moving forward. Never give up on your hopes and dreams, because these are the fuel necessary to push you into who you want to be. Pursue your dreams with action, and you will be undefeatable in the face of obstacles. Keep pushing forward and never look back, just as we taught you how to pass a baton at fitness. Push with all of your heart and spirit, and you'll soar to great lengths to accomplish your dreams. To all parents present, we would not be here today without your guidance and support. You are all the foundation of our education, and the risk you have taken to send your child to Xavier has finally paid off. We all made it, and we dedicate all of our accomplishments to you all. To my parents, salamat kayo sa tanan. Nanagin ko diri sa stage, naghimo og speech. Thank you for all of your support. Nahumanagid ko sa Savior. Most especially, I want to give gratitude to the Jesuit education that I have acquired here in Savior. These Jesuit values of selfless service, cura personalis, or care for the whole person, and being a man and woman for and with others will be woven into my heart as I leave Savior. These values have shaped me into the person I am today, and I believe I speak on behalf of my classmates when I say that these Jesuit teachings have sculpted us to becoming better people. With special gratitude, I want to thank all the people who made my Jesuit education possible and for molding me into the person I am today. Xavier's mascot is a traditional navigator because navigators are known to be strong, resilient, and most importantly, adaptable. They make do with the resources they have while sailing out in the open ocean. I truly believe that all Xavierites embody these values of strength, resilience, and adaptability. They sail through the many uncertainties in the ocean of Xavier, but their courage allows them to overcome the obstacles that may come their way. During my time here in Xavier, I have gained the knowledge and wisdom necessary to overcome many harsh waves that I may face. My experiences here at Xavier are the most precious and unforgettable memories that I hold dearly in my heart. They hold a special place in my heart, and I will never forget them. All of those sleepless nights working on research papers, video projects, or studying for quizzes are memories that I forever cherish. I speak on behalf of my fellow classmates when I say that all of these experiences that we went through here are precious, irreplaceable memories. My classmates are probably cringing right now, but I really just want to say a big fat thank you to each and every one of you, my big brothers. My life in Xavier would not be the same if it was not for your presence, guidance, takeout plates, and camp meet. I will never forget each and every one of you, and I hope all the memories we shared together will leave an impact on all of you. All of our memories of shopping at night together, eating together, going on our retreats, jamming to Twice and Blackpink, blasting out Chuki's Riafu songs, and enjoying each other's presence. These past 4 years have been hectic, stressful, and long, but whenever I look back at them, all I can do is feel happy that I got to meet each and every one of you. You guys have been the pillars of my Savior life, and I hope these pillars stay strong even after we go our separate ways. All the memories we created together are precious to me because they will be the only thing I have left when we go our separate ways. Thank you guys very much for all that you have done for me throughout my time in Savior. You guys were there during my lonely times, and I'm forever grateful for your presence. Your support was one of the only things that kept me going in Savior and pushed me to pursue my dreams. You guys cheered me on when I needed motivation, and that was more than enough for me to keep pushing here in Savior. I will never forget the times when you guys brought your iron to iron my clothes, brought me food when I needed it, kept me company when I was lonely, became a shoulder to lean on, went with me to Bernie's to buy slippers, and gave me mosquito repellent at night to keep the mosquitoes away. Truly, you guys are the only reason why I'm standing up here giving this speech to tons of people present. These memories are irreplaceable because we have gone through so many things as high school students. You guys hold a special place in my big fat heart, and it will always remain there. Even when the sky is falling, even if the sun doesn't shine, all the memories we share together will remain. As I end my speech, I want to return to the song that I chose to describe my Savior journey, We Know the Way, from Moana. There is a verse that most especially describes my time in Savior, which goes, we know where we are, we know who we are. Before I came to Savior, I had no idea what would happen, and all I had to do was participate and not anticipate, according to Father Hadi. But now, I have found the person that I truly am. This verse tells me that throughout the uncertainties of sailing, we come out better people who have a better sense of who they are and who they aspire to be. I really don't want to end this speech just yet, because this will probably be the last time all of us are together in one place. Life will have its uncertainties, but the compass that you're all wearing on your wrists right now, from Miss Margie, will always be a message of direction. Wherever we may be, wherever we may go, and whatever we may face, we are all resilient navigators who will always find our way. Our time at Xavier has come to an end, but our time to set the world on fire has just begun. Begun. As Moana's ancestors conveyed, only you know where you will be, and only you know who you will be. Si Popeye tune on fan soda si Paul my Pyronautz. Anything tong geri geri. Thank you.
Thank you, writer, for that inspiring speech. Our seniors will now make a special presentation in recognition and thanks to some very important people. May I call upon Miss Sarah Simon and Miss Evelyn Pedras, the girls' representatives this school year, to come forward.
The 80s has been for many families here on water to host Xavier students. Some family hosts more than one young woman over the course of their Xavier educations. Many of the boys have sponsors as well and spend time away from Mabuchi Hill on the weekend.
It would be impossible for so many young women to have a Xavier education without the help of sponsored families. We are grateful for sponsored parents for opening up your homes to us and sharing everything you have with us. Thank you for your generosity and hospitality and for making us your children. We would never be able to thank you enough. With a small act of gratitude, we would like to present you a certificate of appreciation as a symbol of our deep love and gratitude.
Mrs. Melba Stinnett Isaac and Yadvin Isaac and Bill Stinnett and Miss Sarah Nobuo for Jazzy Kika Albert and Isabella Kostika.
Mrs. Maurita and Tony Bloy for Paul Partolomo Jr. Moving on. Mrs. Diane Kaminaga and Mr. Rex Kaminaga for Grant Huston, Denzel Donner, and Paul Partolomo Jr. Mrs. Patricia Desime and Mr. Minoru Stephen and Mr. Desime Kofot for Yuri Jose, Denzel Donra, and Anken Perman. Dr. Rita Mori and Mr. Morimori and Mr. Akapito Mori for Glenn Joseph, Mrs. Day Paul and Mr. Jason Paul for Glenn Joseph.
Thank you.
I'm sorry, as well as Mrs. Rosalind Reynolds and Mr. Cesar Reynolds. Mrs. Frida Irons and Jerry Irons for Evelyn Ava Petrus. Mrs. Javina Chiro and Mr. Calvin Asito for Myla Liangergy. Mrs. Joyce Osawa Robert and Representative Johnny Robert, Mrs. Marco Amarich and Mr. Jerry Robert for Maya Leopatu.
Excuse me if I pronounce your names wrong. Next, we have Mrs. Shirley James Silik and Ralph Hawk for Sean Angelo Maluchlu. Again, for Sean Angelo Maluchlu and Kaipo, Mrs. Jenny Rodriguez and Renan Rodriguez. Mrs. Jacinta Paul and Jonas Paul for Nia Robert. Mrs. Daisy Arnold and Roger Arnold for Sarah Eddie Simon. Next, for Kaipo Sigra, Mrs. Rinda Rose Massard and Valerio Massard, Mrs. Rina and Mr. Dickinson Doyce, and Mr. Jay Kokis. For Deshaun Skilly, Dr. Ana Maria Nian Acapito Yomai, and Dr. Felix Yomai. Thomas, Mrs. Maymay Remit and Goody Rain, Mrs. Ophelia and Dr. Kennedy Remit. Mrs. Joylene Setic and Adson Ata Setic Jr. for Layla May Walton. Please join us again in thanking our sponsor families with another round of applause.
Thank you to the diplomas, we will also present awards to several members of this graduating class. I now ask Ms. Margie and Ms. Stephanie to come forward and read the final honor roll list for the fourth quarter for the class of 2023. Ms. Margie and Ms. Stephanie.
Graduates, please stand when your name is called to be recognized. We'll begin with the second honors. Ms. Gina Lynn Nedelik. Mr. Iguamen Na Steven. Mr. Paul Bartolome Jr. Ms. Nia H. Robert. Ms. Melarisa Nathaniel Mori. Mr. Grant Namara Huston. Ms. Asanti Laynette Enlet. And Mr. Denzel Jaden Donrev.
All right, and now for our first honors, Mr. Talon Naveen Killian. Mr. Reiner Franz Rodriguez. Mr. Kaiko Reed Sigra. Mr. Anakin Young Perman. John Spence Asher Spence. Ms. Jamarin Sound. Mr. Sean Angelo N. Mabuchi. Ms. Maya Learaftu. Ms. Isabella Sofia Costa. Miss Sarah Edith Simon. Miss Evelyn Ava Petris. Mr. Glenn Wigan Joseph. Miss Jada Nation M. Iron. Ms. Natalie Tulpe Nacho Thomas. Ms. Yuri Jose. Ms. Angeline Tia Tommy. Ms. Layla Mae Walter. Ms. Hokulani Kata Lindell. Alita Nana Cheney. And last but not least, Ms. Melani Langerchi. Congratulations to you all.
Thank you, Ms. Barge and Ms. Stephanie. The Xavier High School Commencement Awards recognizes senior students who have used their talents to demonstrate the school's values in an exemplary way. I now call upon our school registrar, Ms. Joan Riza Carl, to read the names of the recipients of these awards. Father Thomas Todd of the Society of Jesus, director of Xavier High School, will present these awards to our seniors, assisted by Principal Cobb.
The mission of Xavier High School is to educate all our students to be competent, conscientious, and compassionate leaders whose lives are guided by the Christian call of service. The Leadership Award is given to a student who makes good decisions. He has gained the respect of his peers and has shown guidance through words and by example. The 2023 Leadership Award is given to Talon Naveen Killian. Responsibility Award. As they progress from freshman year onward, students are invited to accept increasing responsibility for organizing groups of their peers as prefects and student senate members. The Responsibility Award is given to a student who has accepted significant responsibilities through his own motivation. The 2023 Responsibility Award is given to Reiner Franz Villajador Rodriguez. Service Award. Xavier strives to develop men and women who willingly use their talents for the common good of others. The Service Award is given to a student who thinks of others before herself, frequently taking on tasks that benefit the Xavier community and improve the lives of others without any desire for recognition. The 2023 Service Award is given to Netta Nachen Chensi. Award. Over the course of their 4 years on Mabuchi Hill, the class of 2023 has proven that it has the Savior spirit, motivating academic and athletic teams to victories. The Savior Spirit Award is given to a student who proudly and enthusiastically supports Savior High School and truly embodies the Savior spirit. The 2023 Spirit Award is given to Natalie Tulpe Nachua Thomas. Effort Award. In addition to assessing students' academic performance in each subject area, teachers also evaluate their effort. The Effort Award goes to a student who consistently shows commendable effort in all classes, judged by his effort average over the past 4 years. The 2023 Effort Award goes to Reiner Villador Rodriguez. Profile Award. Each quarter, teachers evaluate students' development in showing the values of responsibility, concern for others, integrity, and initiative. The Profile Award for Character Development goes to a student who has demonstrated the four profile values, judged by his profile average over the past 4 years. The 2023 Profile Award goes to Reiner Franz Villador Rodriguez. Musician Award. Today, we have been blessed by the musical skills of the class of 2023. The Musician Award is given to a student who has graced school masses, retreats, and other activities with exceptional musical talent, and who has led other students in song. The 2023 Musician Award is presented to Melarisa Netanyong Mori. Athletics Award. Among the class of 2023 are students who have trained to represent Xavier High School in interscholastic sports. The Athletics Award is given to a male student and a female student who have dedicated themselves to strengthening their natural abilities. These two young athletes have willingly used their skills to represent Xavier on multiple athletic teams and have led their classmates in different athletic endeavors. The Athletic Award is given to Sean Angelo Napier Malucci. And Yuri Jose. Yeah! Hard Worker Award. In describing students' classroom performance, the faculty often note particular student as hard worker, who dedicates herself completely to any task which they are given. The Hard Worker Award recognizes a student who has given time, energy, and focus to everything she does. The Hard Worker Award is given to Jaita Nachen M. Irons. Improvement Award. The Improvement Award is given to a student who has developed in significant ways through his education at Xavier. He has become more focused and more well-rounded. The Improvement Award is given to Iguame Nas Stephen.
Carl, Father Todd, and Mr. Carl. In addition to our Xavier Awards, we are very blessed this year to have another award and recognitions. May I ask the representative, Mr. Ray, of the Chuuk State Scholarship to come forward and present their awards and recognition.
I am happy and fortunate to represent not only the Chuuk State Scholarship, but the rest of the Department of Education in recognizing these excellent Navigators of Fire. I have with me here four different awards, but I think they go to two people. Join me in applauding this year's Valedictorian, Mr. Reiner Rodriguez, for his excellent academic performance. Along with academic performance, we also would like to recognize the students' outstanding conduct. So with that, I present to you the Outstanding Behavior Award. And the second student who is presented the Best Conduct or Outstanding Behavior Award is also our class salutatorian, Miss Isabella Costica. Congratulations, and in the word of Sabukis, Oyak Kirisu Jabu.
It is so, Mr. Ray. I now call upon our senior college counselor, Ms. Margie, to announce some university awards of our graduates. Ms. Margie.
In 2021, Fairfield University in Connecticut launched a full tuition and cohort-based scholarship program called the Company Scholars, that offers 12 four-year full tuition grants to students who attend Jesuit and Cristo Rey high schools. As part of the program, students will engage in service projects and outreach with a focus on social justice. This year, one of our graduates has been blessed with the opportunity to attend Fairfield University as a company scholar. Join me in congratulating Mr. Reiner Franz Viajador Rodriguez. The United States Coast Guard is the maritime security, search and rescue, and law enforcement service branch of the United States Armed Forces and one of the country's 8 uniformed services. We are proud to announce to you that one of our graduates has been accepted into the U.S. Coast Guard Academy. He will receive free tuition for 4 years. Our graduate plans to pursue a degree in mechanical engineering, and his training begins next week. Please join me in congratulating Kaipo Reed Segra from the State of Texas.
Thank you, Miss Margie. I now call upon Brother Benedict of the Society of Jesus to announce the recipients of the APIC Sophia University Scholarship.
Through the help of Mr. Soji Sato, former ambassador of Japan to the FSM, Xavier High School has established a long-term relationship with Sophia University, the Jesuit University in Tokyo, Japan. Ambassador Sato has also worked closely with the Association for the Promotion of International Cooperation to establish the APIC, or Sophia Scholarship. Mr. Peter Sato has also been extremely helpful in this regard. The scholarship is a full tuition scholarship, including room and board, to attend Sophia University. I'm happy to announce that the recipients of the Sophia Scholarship of the school year 2022-2023 are Miss Yuri Jose from Palau, and Miss Isabella Sophia Kotska from Belgium. Congratulations to both of you, and thank you.
Thank you, Brother Benedict. Father Matthew Cassidy of the Society of Jesus, the Jesuit Community Superior here in Chu, will announce the final senior award, the Bishop Kennally Award. Father Thomas Todd, the Director of Xavier High School, will present the award.
Good afternoon. Our final award, the Bishop Vincent Kennally Award, is given to the senior who, in the opinion of the school, most clearly demonstrates the qualities of St. Ignatius Loyola, the founder of the Society of Jesus. The winner of the Bishop Kennally Award best exemplifies the competent, conscientious, and compassionate people we all strive to be. She is a leader whose life is clearly guided by the Christian call of service. This award includes a $1,000 scholarship. The winner of the Bishop Vincent Kennally Award is bestowed upon Miss Isabella Sophia Costa.
Thank you, Father Matt and Father Todd, and congratulations to all award winners. And now, Ms. Margie will present the candidates for graduation. Ms. Margie.
Xavier Board of Directors, I present to you the Xavier High School Class of 2023. They have completed their course of studies and are prepared to go forth from Xavier, ready to further their education and serve their home communities, island nations, and beyond. I now ask board member Mr. Myron Hashiguchi, class of 1986, to present the diplomas. Mr. Hashiguchi will be assisted by Father Todd, president of Xavier.
Jazzy Kika May Albert. Paul Bartoloma Jr. Nalita Nana Cheney. Netha Naichen Chensi. Hokulani Caitlin Darrell. Denzel Jaden Donreth. Asanti Leinet Enlit. Yuri Jose. Grant Namara Huston. Jaita Nathan M. Iron. Glenn W. Joseph. Talon Naveen Killian. Isabella Sophia Costica. Mylani Leangerchi. Maya Leroftu. Sean Angelo Napil Malichli. Melarisa Netanyahu Mori. Gina Lynn Nedelik. Evelyn Ava Pedras. Anakin Young Herman. Mia H. Robert. Reiner Franz Viajedo Rodriguez. Sarah Edith Simon.
Look at Sarah.
Kaipo Reed Segra. Deshaun Spence Asher Skilling. Jamarin Sound. Iguama Naz Steven. Natalie Tulpe Natural Tanner. Angeline Tia Tommy. but not least, Layla May Walker.
Thank you, Mr. Hashiguchi and Ms. Margie. I now call upon Mr. Hashiguchi again, board member, class of 1981, to officially confer the diplomas on the graduates. Mr. Hashiguchi.
Okay, seniors, please rise. By the power vested in me as a member of the Board of Directors of Xavier High School, I now pronounce you graduates of the class of 2020. Ladies and gentlemen, I proudly present to you the graduates of Xavier High School, class of 2023. Please join me in offering our congratulations. Have an applause if you see on the box.
Thank you, Mr. Hashiguchi. Congratulations, graduates. Now I will call on the graduates to sing their graduation song.
To a place so far away, letting dreams
Thank you, graduates. That was a beautiful song. Mr. Carl, principal of Xavier High School, will now offer the closing remarks on behalf of Xavier High School. Mr. Carl.
Good afternoon. With humility, I join all the speakers today in offering my utmost respect to our Heavenly Father for the blessings that we receive on this special day. I would like to recognize our traditional leaders among us, especially our Sabuk chiefs. Thank you for loving us and keeping us safe. Sabuk is on fire because of your protection and care for us. Thank you, chiefs from Sabuk. To our mayor of Wena, thank you for hosting Xavier on your island. I also like to recognize and show respect to our government leaders, national, state, and municipal. President Simina, Governor Narun, President Connie, Speaker Mersai, Vice President Gillian, Chief Justice Robert, Mr. Rashkishi, and all who are present here during this our graduation. To our families, friends, alumni, staff and faculty, and especially to the students here, thank you for all that you do for us. In this brief remark, I would like to focus on gratitude. My emotions are running wild because of the deep sense of gratitude and appreciation in my heart. I thank God for most, for it is with Christ that this mission is possible. Be it known to all who enter this campus that Jesus Christ is the reason for this school. Jesus Christ is the model of our faculty and inspiration for our students. May His name be glorified in all that we do. The Society of Jesus is a blessing to Xavier. I offer words of appreciation to the U.S. East Province of the Society of Jesus and the Indonesian Province for their immense support with finance and manpower. Thank you, Society of Jesus. To our benefactors, I appreciate all benefactors, known and unknown, who have supported and continue to support Xavier mission. With your support, Xavier is able to operate and perform as an educational institution. Thank you for your tributes, which have helped sustain Xavier through the year. Thank you, FSM government and Chuuk State, for your annual aid to non-public school subsidies. There is an impact of your subsidies on our daily operation. However, if the subsidy is increased, I really believe that our student will no longer eat mackerel on Friday. Rather, they will be enjoying steak and mashed potato. Yes! So, student, please let us ask our national leaders and state leaders to give more to Xavier so that, as the saying goes, if your stomach is filled, then your brain is also filled. To our sponsor families, we thank you for hosting and taking care of our girls. Thank you for your hospitality and generosity. The education of our girls is possible because of you. Thank you for raising them and protecting them and taking care of them. to our alumni. Thank you, those who have come and those who may be still out there watching this ceremony. Thank you for your support. The support in money or finance, the support in kind, especially when some of you help out coaching, track, basketball, helping out with our entrance exam on the different islands. Thank you for your participation in our activities and for your words of encouragement. And with your sympathies and empathies, we are very grateful. We are also grateful for your constructive criticism of us. We accept them because we know you love Xavier. And because you are so moved by that love for Xavier, I challenge you to please start giving back to Xavier by maybe start with providing some local ropes, some coconut leaves, so that we can finish our cultural huts at the other side, so that we can show our Micronesian culture. And if you are so moved in your heart with fire, you can start donating to the construction of this roof, of this basketball court, so that next year we will not be under the tent. I pray that all may be one in this effort. To our students, you are beautiful and handsome, and thank you for loving and caring for Xavier. Thank you for the hard work you put into your studies, maybe sometimes. Thank you for doing your homework, maybe not. Thank you for doing your projects, maybe. And studying your exams. Thank you for the time you put in your daily chores. Thank you for keeping our campus clean. And thank you for your friendship and the family bond that you created on this campus. Thank you for accepting the challenges thrown at you by your teachers. And thank you for challenging your teachers with your relevant and sometimes irrelevant questions. Thank you for your love and respect that you give to me and the school. And I also like to say thank you for your obedience in writing 500 lines, "I will respect myself and respect Xavier." Thank you for doing Saturday work, afternoon detention, morning glory, cleaning the classrooms, feeding the pigs, cleaning the bathrooms, and cutting grass. Oops, I think I need to stop here, otherwise I'll be in trouble. Corporal punishment. Faculty, thank you. You have gone through so much this year. You began your journey not knowing if you could make it to Mapuche. Then you were on a special flight to come to Xavier. Thank you, Task Force and Chuuk State, for allowing us to come. I don't know how you survived this year. Different culture, tropical diseases, challenging students, living in an international community, and with different personalities among yourselves. I appreciate your dedication and commitment to Xavier. Truly, you did your best despite the foreign land and culture that you live in, and especially with rowdy and sometimes annoying teenagers. Thank you, teachers, for your generosity and contributing to Xavier this school year. I would like to mention, I'm very grateful for the 5 teachers who are remaining for next year to continue the mission here at Xavier. So I would like to call on Father Matt, Father Hadi, Brother Penick, Brother Tebe, and Miss Margie. Without you, I think next year will be more challenging. So please, let's recognize these teachers. 4 teachers are also leaving us today, maybe tomorrow or Sunday. And we want to also recognize them for their service to Xavier this school year. We have Miss Stephanie, Miss Hannah, Mr. Joe, and Mr. Heaven. Please. To the graduates, your class is awesome. Period. I was happy, and I'm still happy, and I will continue to be happy because I met you. Please don't make me cry. I never cry in front of people. We have worked together, and there were times when we had failures, but those failures did not stop us from doing good. Our failures have made us stronger and more resilient. We were beaten down, but never wavered. I'm proud of what you have done and achieved as individual and as a class. You are my true champions. Thank you for being the person and the class you are. It is indeed a privilege and honor to work with you for the past years. Most importantly, thank you for your generous contributions to Xavier. I appreciate your leadership, your service, your artistic talents and musical talents, your athleticism, your joy, your love, and care for the school. Thank you for leading your peers for the past year. Indeed, we're going to miss you. As we come to the end of this ceremony, I want to make a moment to congratulate each one of you. You have worked incredibly hard and to reach this moment, and it is true testament of your dedication and perseverance. As you move forward into the next chapter of your lives, I encourage you to continue to seek out new challenges and opportunity. Remember that your school, high school diploma is just the beginning of your journey, and there is so much more out there waiting for you. I have no doubt that each and every one of you will go on to do great things and I continue to wait to see what you will accomplish. Congratulations again, and best of luck in all your future endeavors. But please don't forget, when you are done with college, remember a place called Mabuji Hill that needs teachers and administrators, and maybe a new principal. When you are rich, please remember the Mabuji Hill. As always, fall in love and stay in love. Thank you and congratulations.
Thank you, Mr. Cobb. I now call upon Father Matt, the Superior of the Jesuits in Micronesia, to offer our benediction.
Good afternoon again. So we open with a prayer. Let us now close with a prayer. Where do you take? Gracious and loving God, we ask for your almighty hand to be upon these graduates as we send them out to navigate the deeper waters of life. With their classes and grading complete, may they strive towards excellence in all that they do. With the applause quieted, may they celebrate and lift up those around them. With the speeches concluded, may their voices rise up to pronounce peace and justice in our world. With the fanfare ceasing, may they find bliss in future endeavors and adventures. With their diplomas in hand, may their achievements grow and enrich their new communities. As Jesuit educated, may they discover holiness in the midst of life's blessings and life's challenges.
As they navigate beyond Mabuchi Hill, may they conduct their life's work with competency, conscientiousness, and compassion, inspired to go forth and set the world on fire. And may Almighty God bless you. Amen.
Thank you, Father Matt. After the recessional song, the graduates will proceed to the slope for a formal photograph to be taken. After the photo, the graduates will proceed to the sidewalk in front of the library and the senior classroom, where family, friends, and guests may go to congratulate them. Dinner will follow here on the basketball court. Thank you, and congratulations to the Pyronauts.
I'm gonna On a boat, taking chill, up a hill, baby, trying to get a meal. Mary had a little lamb, I really do not fuck with that. She calling me the muffin man, I surely like the muffin top. Slow. Hey.
Thank you.
Yes, that's it. Take the picture. Take the
Rainer, congratulations.
Thanks.
Finally.
Is this for the vlog?
Mm-hmm.
Hey guys, I'm out of here.
Congratulations.
Hey father.
Have you seen Salsa? She's crazy. Yeah, I already see.
There.
Yeah, with the wings.
Jenna, her kids.
The other one.
Children.
Here.
No.
What's your name?
Children.
Here.
Children.
Children.
Oh, sorry. Where's your mom?
Your mother. Yes.
Ready? Run. And then hold it up.
Wow. So that one. Yes, I like that one. Ready? Yeah. One, two, three. Hey. Stop it.
Wow, Kika!
Thank
Yeah.